What's up, guys? In this video, we're gonna be showing you how we built this 12-foot V-Haul tin boat into a bass boat. How we made these power poles and the whole nine yards. So stay tuned. Should be a good one. All right. We got the seats out yesterday. Just had to take off a bunch of these washers, rip them out. I'm gonna sand this thing down. I'm gonna end up painting it matte black with some spray paint. And I figured it'd be a better paint job if I just sanded it down, made it a little smooth. So yeah, here we go.
All right, guys. So we turned this boat in from that little red little tin can you seen in the beginning of the video. I got that boat for $350 at the beginning of last year. And yeah, it came with the trailer, the boat, it was a great deal. My buddy, just his neighbors were getting older and it was just sitting in their yard and they just ended up giving it to him. And he didn't have the space in his house to store it or whatever. So he just posted on like a Snapchat story. Anybody want a boat? $500. So I pulled up to his house and gave him like $350. Take it or leave it. So here we are. There she is. All right, just got done sanding. Just got all the paint chips out of the rivets and stuff, all along the edges. Gave her a little bath. So we're gonna start painting it. Just hitting it with the rattle can right now. It's gonna take a couple coats. It's pretty windy right now, so kind of wasting a lot of paint, but yeah, we'll come back when it's, we got the first coat on. All right, this is the first coat. A little patchy, but she's looking like $1 million. You don't gotta tell me twice. All right, it's pretty dark. Probably can't even see me, but probably can't see the boat either. It's just drying off right now. Gonna go inside for probably an hour, come back out, put those tarps on it, come back out in the morning, and we'll see how she looks. All right. We started the framing today. Just got some 16th inch angled aluminum. We're hand riveting them in with this thing. It's pretty sweet. If you are looking to go the rivet route, this is a budget tool. It works really well. But yeah, we're just boom, 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 putting in the angled aluminum. Yeah. Come back to you when we get the supports going across. All right, so we got the lines for where these supports gotta go. So we got enough room for our deck. And we were trying to figure out a way to support these to the side of the boat. So what we're gonna do is cut out a little like 2-inch piece and we're gonna put it right here. We're gonna rivet it right here and then this is gonna get riveted to the side of the boat. So I'm just gonna kinda like it like that. Yeah. Pretty mean. Alright, quick update on the framing here. Coming along, we get these L brackets going. Little rivet action. You know the deal. Just gotta rivet that side in. We ran into a little issue here. We were putting this whole piece together at once, but then we got to this part and the edge of the boat is at a curve, so we couldn't just put it
directly on, like at a 90. So I'm just putting these on first, and then I'll put both of them on, and then I'll drill a hole, put the angle of the aluminum across, and I'll rivet it after I get the two L's in. So yeah, I don't know if that's helpful, but it helped me out. So. All right, we got another update on these hatches. Coming along pretty good. I ran out of rivets though, so I'm just kind of putting this together, seeing how it would look. This is I'm gonna end up riveting this edge to this support right here. I don't know, I might run some, maybe like something going across right here, support this side. And yeah, but how I'm doing this, I've seen, I forget this dude's name on YouTube, but I saw him doing this pretty cool design with the angled aluminum. You just measure around the box and you just cut one side. So like right here, you'd measure right to this line and then you'd cut just this side and then it bend at a 90 right over here, then another 90. But this last piece was too short, or yeah, the piece of aluminum I was using was too short to go all the way around, so I cut another piece, kind of same deal, just lined it up like that on each side. I still got to cut that side, but I'm just gonna fold it over like that, drill a hole, rivet it, and that should be pretty secure. Yeah, I'll come back to you when it's done. Yeah, so this is 1/16 inch. Pretty sure I've mentioned that multiple times, but yeah, it's kind of tough to bend with your hands. Unless you're like Ronnie Coleman. So, doing the old double ply. Yeah, you just gotta be careful when you're bending this that you don't break that. I kind of just felt a little. Yeah, I'm not gonna. It's kind of bent. I'm gonna see if I can just flatten that out. Lines. You want to do the least amount of bending as possible, because that'll weaken this little joint right here. It'll end up snapping off. So yeah, just try to get it right the first time, I guess. Yeah, that was pretty solid. This is just gonna go right here. Chopping these flush, and probably gonna have to end up sanding this down a little. It's not coming up a little bit. Just gonna get that flush with the hand sander. Yeah, get back to you when it's done.
Got the framing all finished up. Now we're just framing in these hatches. I made some L brackets there, made them there, putting in rivets to the backside. This is gonna be where our front hatch will be. Have another one back here. Got an angled aluminum coming up this way, so I'll have a bucket in here. That way the water can run off the sides there. So we got a couple rivets in now. We're gonna finish this one up, get the back hatch in. It's gonna go right there. Same deal for that one. And we'll get back with you guys once this part's finished.
All right, yeah. So the main purpose of these little boxes I made for my Tupperware things is the water, like my hatch will be bigger than this around, so when water drips off it, it'll drip down onto this and off and down there through my little leak system I got going on. But Yeah, so I didn't have enough metal to go around, like I said. So you see like those cracks right there. I just flex sealed them. That one's not really holding, but it's close enough where I think I can just hit it again and it'll be good. But this one had a pretty big gap. So I put a piece of metal behind it and I just riveted it in. And yeah, that should be good now. So come back to you a little bit.
All right, guys, so we just traced the deck out with some cardboard and a Sharpie. And so now we're just finishing the outline cut. We're gonna take that cardboard, put it on the plywood. Then we're gonna go ahead and take this jigsaw right here to it, cut out the outline for our deck and see how it fits up. Hopefully it's a perfect fit, and then we can go in with the circular saw and make the hatches. So once we get this deck outline onto the plywood and all cut out, we'll give you guys an update.
Yeah, I haven't really been filming today, but we got some stuff done here. We're working on this. This is where my seat is going to be mounted. And these are just like here, existing. And I bought the boat. So I took 2L angled aluminums and I put them in between these two for support. And I'm putting this little plate on top of it. Gonna rivet it down. Just gotta do these last two, and then my seat plate will be mounted along the angled aluminum right here and right here. So yeah, figured that would be the strongest way. I don't know, strongest way I could think of with the stuff I got. So
gonna get to it. All right, so we're using these brackets that have already been installed when we got the boat, those two, and what we're doing is cutting V notches in them, in each one of them, you can see, and that's gonna house this right here, which is gonna be our support for the floor. We got one on that side, one on here. We use 1/16 for the framing of the rest of the boat, but for this floor support, we're going with, it's 1/8 by 1 inch. Angled aluminum, bit more money, but this stuff's pretty thick and it's real strong. So we're gonna use that for the floor. So if you can get away with using that, I'd probably have to suggest that. This stuff's looking pretty solid so far. So we're gonna install this second one in the brackets. We got to finish taking the grinding wheel to them and opening up these holes a little bit for this angled aluminum to sit in there. So we'll get to it.
All right, I did some work yesterday, a couple hours. It was horrible conditions, real windy last night. I had these tarps set up, but yeah, that didn't work. Now I got
ice right here. That's not good.
Anyway, yesterday I got these two back hatches all framed up. This is where my seat's gonna go. Kind of just took the grind out of that, made it flush. I had to extend the wood down here so I could fasten this piece to that end from the bottom, because this, I didn't want to rivet through this. This is aluminum, and I didn't like how low I was gonna have to rivet. I don't have like waterproof rivets. I just have like old cheap 3/4 or 3/16 inch ones. But yeah, now I'm gonna cut out the tops for these, cut out the hatches, and probably try to carpet it today. I try to carpet my floor and maybe the deck too. See how far we get. Yeah, here we go. Not bad. Alright, yeah, I'm an idiot. So what I did is I got these little pieces of cardboard and I cut them out in these hatches. Yeah, so I did it so it was flush with the edge, like that, kind of, roughly. And so I'm gonna put another piece of wood, like a panel of wood here and a panel of wood here. And I don't want there to be a seam on each side, so I'm gonna have these overhanging and I'm gonna screw them down so there's not like a crack in between the, you know what I mean? So yeah, I already cut that piece of wood to this size right here, and then I realized that I am in fact an idiot. Oh wait, what am I doing? Is this, yeah, cut this one. Yeah, see that? So it sits pretty good in there. All right, I guess, but I want it to overhang a little more. It's kind of all right on that side, I guess, but this side, not really. I want it to overhang so that other piece of wood can go up right to here and lay like flush against that, and I'll screw them all down. Yeah. Yeah, so kind of got a better lip now. Enough to screw down into. Those are fastened to each other. First one's done. Alright, yeah, Dave's jigsaw just broke. It was his grandfather's from like 500 years ago. Houston, we have a problem. Oh yeah, yeah. Don't look too pretty. I have no idea how I'm gonna fix this. This thing, when I turn it on, it just, this is the on switch. Oh! Yeah, it's not even moving anymore. It was moving, it was just getting jammed. There's something wrong with it. I don't know what. I might have to hit YouTube Academy for this one. This is not an ideal situation. But yeah, it's as far as I got. It still needs a little more trimming, but now moving over to, I just cut out the tough boxes. You just get these at Home Depot. They're like, this one was like 11, the bigger one was like 13 bucks. Yeah, I just cut, there was a lip on it. Yeah, I'll show you the lip. That little lip, I just took the grinder to it. Cut that off. And yeah, now it fits like a glove. Oh, you know what? It does fit. It does fit like a glove, but it fits like a glove because it's ice in there. So I gotta figure something out for underneath, how I'm gonna support it down. I have glue. I don't really wanna just do glue. I might though, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'll figure, I'll get back to you guys. All right, I'm kinda running out of shit to do for my, before I can get my jigsaw fixed. I don't know what's good with that thing. I gotta take some serious time, but I just took the sander to this and now it finally fits flush. So I'm gonna mark out the hatches right now. That don't sound good. Yeah, I tried firing up the hose for this ice. There's ice all over there. That thing's frozen, so. Good for me. Ah, here we go. We're just gonna trace out the bark. Oh, this is tight. Yeah, here we go. So, my latch, my first one is gonna be right here. I'm gonna try my best. There's not a lot of room down here to trace this out. And then I'm probably gonna end up measuring off this trace to the next one because I can't get up there, as you guys can see. So, I guess I'll just keep this going right here. Show you guys. Yeah, I'm not sure this is the best way to do it, but this is how I'm doing it. Oh my god, I can't move. Alright, we were trying to trace out this front hatch, and as you can see, there's no room to get your arm in there to trace it out. So, came up with a pretty good idea. We put some paint down. I cut this part out for my hatches. This is where my little Tupperware bin's gonna sit in. And we just put paint all around the side of it, and then just lightly placed it on there, pushed it down, and it gave us like a decent little outline. And we just used that. We measured the boxes. It didn't give us one over here, so we just measured the dimensions of this and drew it out. So yeah, now we got it all drawn out. We're gonna cut it. It's gonna be neat. Yeah, this one we can reach, so I'm hitting it with the Sharpie. Alright, we got the hatches cut out here. Guys, haven't been focused too much on filming. Just been trying to get all these last pieces done. Getting close to the end here, but I just wanted to show you guys this little tip I did, because this is going to be my hatch, and you can't just cut like this and fold over in here. So I'm going to have to cut at a 45 right here on every side, right there, right there, and they'll fold over, but they'll leave a little gap right here, which is why I put these little strips on every side. And I think that should cover it up, hopefully. I'll show you guys the finished product in a sec. All right, I thought this was a pretty cool idea. This is where like my battery's gonna go. Probably have two, one here, and I bought a piece of, I think this is inch PVC, 3/4, I don't know. Forget, bought it like 2 days ago, but yeah, so I just riveted another L to the support all the way down. And I'm just I drilled two holes. And I'm just zip tying it so it stays flush and it bends to the side of my boat. Yeah.
Came out pretty nice. I like how it looks. I just gotta put one more up here so it's not in the way. See how it's kind of poking out? That's where my hatch is gonna be. So, yeah, pretty clean. Not a bad idea. Pretty good budget way of getting your electrical up to the front of your boat.
All right, we're just doing the foam right now. We're not doing like foam to make it float. We're just doing foam so no bees and rats or anything gets inside there once the deck goes down, because we're not really going to be able to access underneath here once the deck goes down. But yeah, we're using a big gap filler up to 3 inches. It kind of sucks, but it's like the only stuff they got at Home Depot. So, yeah. There it is.
All right. Here it is, guys. Got the deck on, floor down. But yeah, here's the hatches. Got those kind of hinges on there. Those look real clean when you close it and stuff. Yeah. I think that looks a lot better than like door hinges or whatever other guys use, but yeah, came out pretty good. I got all my tools and stuff in here because I'm still working, but yeah, this is closes up real nice. It's legit. Pretty legit. Today I'm gonna be working on this front transom mount that I gotta make for my troll motor. I cut out all these. I had to make them the right size. I made them 4 inches tall because I want this motor to be sitting. When it's all the way down like that, without that piece of angled aluminum there, because it's just kind of holding it up. But it's going to be flush. It's going to be like that. That's about 4 inches. And I didn't want it to be any bigger, because I want my troll motor as deep as I can. So yeah, and I made it. I just measured across right here. It's like 8 inches. Made it 3. I used my extra marine grade 3/4 inch plywood, putting 3 of them together. I'm gonna screw them in some wood screws right now, and then I'll probably sand down the sides. That side's looking pretty rough. I'll get back to you guys. The front transom mount all put together. Just used 2 1/8 angled aluminum pieces right here, and then the 3/4 inch Brook Marine grade. It's just three pieces stacked up. And we just wood screwed them in. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah. That thing ain't moving. Solid as my bicep. Peep. This actually fits. Yeah, what? Pretty slick. Alright, what's up guys? We're in the middle of building these shallow water anchors. They're like power poles. Just gonna show you what we did here. There's so we got the PVC pipe right here. Got a string attached to the bottom of it. Runs up through this little hole, around this pulley, back down through that hole. So essentially this is how it's gonna work. We just got this one hooked up. Pulls up from the bottom. Just like that. We're gonna probably put a cleat right here or something. Still gotta figure that out, and just that's how we're gonna tie it off when it's done. But also another cool thing that we did is we made it fold down 90 degrees. My hat is in the way, but yeah. So when we're traveling with the boat, we're not gonna have some big 10-foot long PVC pipe hanging out. We just used, where is it? Yeah. This is like a hinge for a fence door. And yeah, we just, stuck that on the bottom with some rivets. Had to tinker with it a little bit. Had to cut a hole because this is how it comes. I had to chop off like that much and then drill out a hole with a unibit so it would fit around that this little grommet PVC thing I made. And yeah, so we just riveted that in, and this would fall, like it would fall all the way down here. So we had to put a L bracket in right here, and yeah, that seems to work. The L bracket stops it, sits at a pretty good angle. Yeah, couple of guys being dudes out here. I just cut off the last little hole part. Just like that. Drill a hole. And then I'm gonna take the unibit to it. Go from either side just to clean up all the scraps around it. Make sure you're gonna be pretty thin on either side here, so make sure you're careful. Yeah,
looks pretty good.
All right, guys, got a quick update on the power poles. We got one pretty close to done here. We just put some sheet aluminum, sheet metal. I don't know if this is aluminum. I don't think it is. But yeah, picked this stuff up at Home Depot. And yeah, cut up a piece with the grinder. I'm gonna clamp it up right here. I know it's like way bigger, but I'll take the grinder and make it flush with that. That's how I did this one. And yeah, cover up all the sides so it makes it look a little more clean. Yeah. Oh, and another thing I didn't mention, this this PVC right here, this little joint, this little grommet thing, it's just like the one of the smallest PVCs you can like find at Home Depot, and I just cut like little pieces and I super glued them in with a lot of super glue right there. I used this stuff, Rapid Fuse. It works pretty well. I'd recommend it. But yeah, so I'm gonna keep going cutting these out and show you how this one goes. Yeah, so to get this aluminum to sit flush as possible, because you got rivets sticking out. Well, I do, because this is how I just cut out like two pieces of angled aluminum, and I riveted them together, and I just made four sides like that. And yeah, so I just had to like put in a bunch of rivets, so they're all like, not all of them break off as clean as that one. Some of them leave a good rod sticking out. So I'm just gonna, got like a little metal file, I'm just gonna file it down as good as I can. Oh yeah, that's it. After I file it down, it should be good. But if you're doing this one man, you gotta probably use some clamps so you can hold it exactly where you want to, and then drill your holes and rivet it. Just play around with this a little. Yeah. So you just lining it up, making sure it's sitting in that corner nice. Yeah, that's good. I'll probably throw another clamp on. And another thing, if you're doing it how I did it with all these rivets hanging out, you don't want to drill these rivets into those rivets. So just make sure you're peeping where those are at. Kind of just eyeball it.
To Deep Space Nine.
So, yeah.
Center for trade.
Yeah, because if you drill into the rivet, you're going to take out your rivet. And,
by forces seeking dominion.
Yeah, you just don't.
A crew
do
committed to.
From an accident.
Yeah, I got to change a bit. This thing's working.
All right, before I start painting, I forgot I got to get my power poles on. So I had these ones before. They're the same size and everything. I just thought I needed to make them two pieces for when I'm traveling, just so I could tuck them away so they're not dragging on the ground. But we made this little hinge setup right here, so these will flip up and the power pole will be facing this way. I'm about to put it in and show you guys what it all looks like done. So yeah, get to it. Yeah, so this is how it's gonna sit in. I just gotta drill a hole right at the bottom here. This is where my rope's coming. This is the rope that's gonna attach. I'm just gonna drill a hole, probably tie like a little clinch. I don't know where I'm gonna tie.
Should probably figure out the best knot for that, but last time I just tried to clinch knot with like three loops instead of six or seven. Seemed to hold up pretty well, so I'm just gonna try that for now. Maybe I'll fix it later, but get back to you when it's all set up in there. Alright, this is the finished product for the power poles. This is how they would go when I'm transporting the boat. I made these little clips right here. Just to hook this on. Yeah, just gotta kind of pull it over. Boom, just like that. So we hit bumps and stuff, it's not going anywhere. This will be tied tight to that, just like this, so the pole won't slide back and forth. But I just had it like this just to show you guys when it's open. This is how. Just like that. Boom. Just like that. Same deal on the other side. I also put in these little rings right here just to guide the rope in like the straightest direction possible, and it's not like grinding up against my my cleats and stuff. I mean, yeah, it'll like rip off the paint. So I thought that was a pretty good idea. Quick, easy, do it yourself power poles. Yeah, right here. You gotta like go slow because the drill's gonna grab it and really, I don't know if it's just my bit or whatever and it's not sharp enough, but you gotta really hold this thing. Bada boom. Right there. Pretty clean. I mean, my hatch thing will just cover that just like that, so you won't even really see any of this stuff. I think the glue really helps it stick down and not fray up. But yeah, there you go. I took my tape measure, measured a halfway point. Just so these look symmetrical. Got a little straight edge, just grabbed a piece of wood that was straight. I'm gonna start drilling these out. Yep, forgot there was a piece of angled aluminum there. It's whatever, just a little hole. Boom. Next one. Line this back. Ooh. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. Cut off some of this carpet that's still attached. Yeah, I'm just gonna get the leaf blower and blow off all this sawdust. Alright, so these latch poles I got are like perfect size for that hole saw bit. It like just barely fits. You can kind of see on this one, I missed one of them right there, kinda. It like went through a tiny bit of the wood. So I just gotta be careful when I'm drilling these in and it's perfectly like on center. So I'm just gonna like hold it in place while I drill. I'm gonna go corner to corner first so that locks it in. Gotta make sure these are facing the right way.
Yeah, see, I'm kind of close on this side, so I'm gonna try to angle this a little bit. Nice.
Boom. Nice.
Should probably be drilling pilots for these, but I don't want to go get my drill bit set. Just being lazy. I just ran in and out of the house like 20 times. I'm just trying to get this done so I can start painting today. I put that the wrong way. I'm an idiot. God. Alright, there we go. That's a lot better. Alright, last one. Last screw for the hatches. Sweet. Oh, this is awesome. We got hatches, boys. Do it yourself. Boom. Also, this hatch, let's see, matches that hatch. It was supposed to be right there, but I need somewhere to put my gas tank, so I scrapped that idea, and I made this little box, and this is just like what I'm gonna throw my baits in and stuff. I made it the right height so it can just slide right in there. It's pretty slick. I might put like a little handle thing or so. Pull it out, but I mean, that's pretty easy. Pull it up, boom, got my bait. Got my, probably my cooler hatch. Who knows what's going in here? I can do anything with these. I got a lot of room now. I'm pumped. I gotta put these in, but first, these are my rod holders. I got four of them. Kind of a lot. I was gonna put them on the back. I think I'm gonna end up putting them like right here. Yeah, that's for down the road. I'm gonna swing this boat around front, hose it off, and start painting. Also, don't know if I showed you guys these. These are just cheap little cup holders I got at West Marine. They're like $5 a pop. Hold my Joe in the morning, whatever kind of beverage I got going. A little beer action, who knows? Pretty slick. $5. Nice and compact design. I like them a lot. Here we go. What's up, guys? We got the seat mount in. It kind of got hacked up a little bit because it was hard to screw down those nuts to those washers, like getting my fingers in there. So I had to make like little holes with the Unibit. And yeah, I should have done it all before I like put my framing down for my floor and like all this stuff. It was just hard to gauge the sequence of work. We just kind of went after this boat, had some free time and took advantage of it. But yeah, it was like 1/4 by 20 bolts and nuts. These are all stainless. And yeah, that's solid in there. Same deal up here. Just had to use shorter ones. I actually had to file these down a little. If you should get like flat heads, like nut ones that stick up a whole lot. You see that? Like, yeah, I had to file them, but. Yeah, I'll put this on and I'll show you guys the whole boat. Alright guys, this is it. The Black Betty Water Sport Edition. This is the seat all mounted in.
That's how it sits in there, just a little cotter pin thing.
Full swivel. Thing's mint. Yeah, these are my rod holders. This is my little 9.9 horse engine. I gotta get it fixed, but it runs, it'll just bog out. So I think I just gotta run some seafoam through it. Yeah, this is that's my trolling motor up here. I gotta get this turned around, so that's facing this way. And my, oh, I didn't screw this down all the way. But yeah, then this thing can like stand up right here. Yeah, pretty sweet. I kind of want to get one of those like step little foot controlled motors. They like lay right here. I don't know. I think it's kind of overkill for this. This is my Garmin too. I don't know where I'm gonna set this up. I could like make a little stand thing for like up here. Maybe put it back here. Right, I'm not sure yet. But yeah, I might do it back here just so I can sit down and like screw around with it, because I'm new with this stuff. I just got this, I have no idea. I mean, I turned it on and like I kind of know how it works. I don't really know how to read it. I mean, I know how to read it kind of, but I haven't done it like in person yet. But yeah, this is it. Money, money, money. Just gotta get my batteries figured out, and I gotta get a new cord for this too, because this is not long enough to run all the way down to my battery box. But yeah, I just gotta flip this head around, get new marine grade wire. I'm not sure what grade wire this is, but yeah, probably like 10 feet or something to get all the way back here. 12 feet, probably, I don't know, maybe more. This is like a 12 foot boat. But yeah, this is it, guys. Not bad. Just let me know what you guys think of this thing, if you had any suggestions, any cool ideas for it. And stay tuned. We're gonna be taking this rig out all spring and summer and fall next year. Should be a great year fishing. So yeah, just shake and bake.
Just thought we'd let you know like how much like material and like everything we needed, because we went to Home Depot like 20 times probably between like the whole build to get everything we needed, because it just kept coming up. Like, we just kept finding that we needed things and we didn't have them, so we had to go get them. But yeah, I don't really have like a list or anything. This is just kind of off the top of my head, but we used like 400 rivets. We used 2 sheets of marine grade plywood. We used like we only used 2 sheets of the just like the sheet aluminum. If you want to use those for the power poles, we used 2 10-foot quarter inch or 3/4 inch PVC pipes, and then you'll need inch PVC pipes, but like one of them, they only sell them in like 8-foot sections at Home Depot, so you'll just need to buy one of those. And I got like a big like 9-foot section in my shed, but yeah, those are just for like the for these. I'll show you real quick. Yeah, like what it slides into, like the pole itself is 3/4, but the pole inside the box is an inch. It's like the just for what it feeds through. But yeah, that we got like 50 feet of that rope. Like these things, we used 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. The fence framing, or the not the frame, the fence hinges, we used 2 of those. Those hinges we used four of those for the hatches. I really like those hinges we use, like that style. I think it looks real nice. Paint. Yeah, we used like, I still got to paint underneath here, like the whole, trailer. I mean, you can't even really tell, and like nobody will really be able to tell but me from looking underneath. But I've used probably 10, 12 cans, I'd say. And then I got like 6 cans of the clear coat, like the Rust-Oleum clear coat, just for like the top finish so it stays. But yeah, that's, I think, pretty much it. I just wanted to tell you a little backstory about the boat. I got it from my buddy TJ. He has some like older neighbors or something. They just weren't using the boat anymore and just gave it to him. And he doesn't really fish or nothing. I think he's more of a saltwater guy. I don't know. It's just a little 12-foot boat. He didn't have a use for it, and he didn't really have space to store it. So he like posted on a Snapchat story. It was like, somebody come grab this boat, $500. So I pulled up and gave him $350. Then came with the trailer, boat, troll motor, outboard, gas tank, 2 batteries. Yeah, it was a steal. And so I'm really pumped with it. I probably spent about, I mean, the wood was, I spent $320 on wood. I think it was $160 or $150 for each 8-foot sheet of plywood. And then the aluminum, all the angled aluminum got kind of pricey. I'd say probably around $200. We had like 90 feet, I think. I think pretty close to 90 feet. We were getting like 8-foot sections or something like that. I forget what it was, but yeah, that was a good bit. The seat was like 80. All the rivets and other stuff. I don't know if I went over $1,000 on building this boat. I'd have to go back and do the math. But yeah, I'm real happy with this for the money we spent and how it came out. And what's gonna come this season for fishing. So yeah, let me know if you guys enjoy the video. Remember to drop a comment, subscribe, whole nine. Thanks.